you don't have to go to second for this one at all. You can carry the momentum.
Okay.
you were just doing it like right away,
yeah,
it's a little more patient and you're getting better at it. So that's good.
Yeah, I'm a lot more comfortable on the track this second time around.
And as a reference, you've been doing low twos the whole time, like 202, 201, and I got a two flat on the last one.
That's
so
good.
One thing that I've noticed is you rush to either shift gears and do all those things, right?
Yeah.
I'd rather you go gentle and slow your lap time.
Okay.
And improve on those things.
Yeah.
To do it all smoothly. It needs to be cohesive. I know you're practicing the rev match thing. That takes time.
I'm blipping the throttle, but I'm missing the shifting at the right point. Yeah.
And if you get frustrated and you know you're in the wrong gear,
just
take pause and just get it to the right thing that you need to do in the smoothest way, because when you're trying to correct, you're just kind of like in a rush.
Yeah,
it's bad on your car. It frustrates you even more.
Yeah,
it's okay to mess up. If you mess up, just clean up. Basically what I do with every botch lap is that I just hit reset. It's like I fucked it up, it's not gonna happen, right? So I start practicing specific things. So like each lap or each session, I know that you don't get the optimal experience to keep repeating the same things because this is too far for you to go.
Yeah.
At least this track, but each track I do, I set specific goals. Mm-hmm. So like the first time is just getting to know the line and the basics.
Yeah.
Forget about lap time, any of those. Then when I get faster and I understand, then I break down each corner. It's like, what do I want to do each corner? And basically kind of chain everything together. So break down each corner, then chain everything together.
Okay.
And basically make it like a goal. Like, you can't eat the whole pizza, you gotta eat one bite at a time.
Yeah.
Right? So try to slow it down in your mind. Don't rush. And kind of work with what you have.
Okay.
So the reason why I had you go into fourth, besides besides that it's faster, is that it's preserving your frustrations. Like, you don't have to worry so much about lifting because you have the rev limiter, any of that. It just eliminates it. Because in theory, if you do everything right, you can keep going around if you want. Cool down. In theory, if you do everything right and say you do it in a higher gear, successfully, you'll be faster than you trying to rush doing it the ideal way.
Yeah. Okay.
Because things that I've done before was at a track that requires, say, second and third, I just sit in fourth and do it all smoothly.
Yeah.
And if I can do everything correctly, in theory, that time is going to be faster than whatever you were rushing with.
Yeah.
And then over time, then you can blend everything in.
Yeah. Okay.
So hopefully that helps.
Yeah, basically, definitely going up to fourth, and I ended up carrying more speed, shifting early into fourth.
Because now you're worried less about
shifting
and holding the revs and whatever, and more focus on actually doing what you need to do on the track to navigate. So I guess if he's going to cross you, you're going to cross too. But
I'm trying to pull up through here.
Yeah. But that's pretty much how I learn each track. Follow somebody who knows the line, or ride along with somebody who knows the line.
Yeah.
Or play on a video game at minimum, or watch videos and stuff like that. But just progressive. Don't rush.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the big thing.
That's a lot of people's mistakes. Some of your inputs are still very aggressive.
Okay.
Like if you feel like it's slow, then you start like correcting at the end.
Yeah.
Let it track out. If you go off, you're going off at a slow speed that you can stop.
Okay.
Like for example, your turn two, that hairpin, you think that you're going off, so you keep giving more steering input. Well, if you do that, you're gonna either understeer or spin.
Yeah.
So I'd rather you straighten it out, you go off, two off or whatever, you get black flag, come back in, it's safer than trying to fix it or spin.
Yeah.
Otherwise, a lot of it's more tracking out more, carrying more speed.
Yeah, some of the turns I was doing okay on, and then...
Because, for example, that right-hander in the middle straight, you can definitely track out more.
Okay.
You're on it,
And yeah. what you're doing is your steering input is actually keeping it inside the track okay. rather than on the berm.
So unwind a little bit more.
Yeah, unwind a little more. Let the speed carry you out.
Yeah.
You can correct on that. And you're actually really good at correcting on the fly.
Yeah.
Like when you think you're about to go off, you do a light lift.
Yeah.
Some of those lifts, just do partial throttle. Don't just like full
lift. Don't
lift
completely.
What you're doing is shifting the weight very sudden.
Yeah.
And you don't want to do that.
Yeah.
The smoother you are, the faster you are. Smooth is fast.
Yeah.
Loose is also fast, but that's another time.
Yeah.
But you did really well. I mean, you're almost there to sub two.
Yeah. I mean, this is only like my third track day. Mm-hmm. And, well, fourth and first time here. Right. So I know there's a lot to go, but yeah, I'd like to break two today. I mean, it'd be nice if I can get into the mid 150s, but we'll see.
Your phone battery is almost dying. It's giving the warning, so
okay, I can charge it.
Yeah,
well, I'm
just give me a heads up. Yeah. Otherwise, all your stuff is good. I'm gonna hit stop for you.
Yeah, I'm gonna. Yeah, thanks. So the fastest one was like a
two flat.
Flat.
Yeah, okay. You got actually two back to back, I think.
Okay.
Too flat on the one when I told you to go into fourth gear or start to go into fourth gear and you were getting comfortable.
Yeah.
So that happened. Yeah, that was like one of your last laps.
Yeah.
So overall, it's pretty good. Start to ease into throttle sooner on turn 7.